All right. Good morning, everybody. I thought I'd do a sort of, I guess what I'm going to do is sort of a blanket or a universal video here. Not really covering anything new in particular for any one particular class, but this sort of just is a generalization of for all my classes. So for my hybrid 1101, for my two online 1101, for my hybrid 1010, for my online 1102. It's just to sort of get everybody on the same page about where the college is sort of going forward as it relates to our meeting yesterday. And again, this is coming from our vice president in a lot of ways. So I did send out an email, and I will share this here momentarily. You should have received the email. Let's see. Earlier. And again, you want to find your particular class, because I did sort of lump everybody up in here. I just thought that would be easier to send one big email, but I think it's sort of self-explanatory in a lot of ways. Of course, if you have questions, you know, particular in your class, please feel free to email me and I will address those as soon as I can. But basically what I'm doing is I'm giving everybody about 24 days to get caught up, because really, in a lot of ways with these weeks, depending on if you're 1101, you probably had more stuff in 1102, but the 1010 classes, whether they're hybrid or online, the 1101 classes, whether they're hybrid or online, you basically only missed like two assignments possibly. Some of y'all have already turned these in, so you are probably caught up and you haven't really missed anything if you have turned it in, because either you are lucky enough to not lose power, or you're able to recover power a lot quicker than most. Now, I realize there's still some folks out there, depending on where you're at, in Georgia, I guess, that may be having some issues with power and internet. The thing is, again, that's why I'm giving everybody 24 days. I've opened up some stuff. I'll go back and make sure that some of the modulars are going to stay open. Basically, I'm giving you until the 31st to get everything caught up and done. So that means also, like, this is week 8, technically midterm week. There's going to be stuff for week 8, week 9, week 10. So in a lot of ways, you want to get that stuff that, you know, is left behind, modular 6, modular 7, caught up, so you're not getting behind in week 8, week 9, and week 10. The thing about the next few weeks, though, a lot of it is just going to be focusing on, at least for my 1010, 1101 class, would be the midterm, the Respondus, if you're strictly online. If you're 100% online, you're going to have to take a Respondus lockdown browser event. Same thing for my 1102. And again, I detail this stuff out in the actual email. So if you go back and kind of read this stuff, it will help you. I'm going to show everybody here momentarily, for those that are strictly 100% online, where you're going to find the information and how you're going to download that Respondus browser if this is your first time with Respondus. Because for every online class, you're going to have to do a Respondus event. It could be for the midterm. It could have been, you know, for some quiz or something early on in the semester. It could be for a final exam. The deal is, I think if we go ahead and do the Respondus, you know, within the next couple of weeks, your December won't be really bogged down because right before final exams, you have a research paper due. So that's sort of the whole deal that we're trying to get caught up and stay on track. So by the time we get to week 10, week 10 and week 11, we can start talking about, and this is for pretty much everybody at this point, the research paper in your class. Because once we get to week 10, you basically have about 5 weeks left in the semester. The college at this point is not going to add additional days to our semester. Granted, you know, we have a couple more weeks of hurricane season, so anything can change, but right now it looks like we're still going to be ending our semester the week of December 9th. Usually there's 2 days for final exams. It's usually, in this case, I think it's going to be December 9th and 10th. So I don't really see them extending, unless, you know, we just are shut down for a long period of time. So that's why I suggest, if you're still struggling with the whole power internet issue, you're going to have to find some public place, whether it's to use a Wi-Fi, whether it's to go to the closest Coastal Pines Technical College, public library. If you're a dual enrollment student, use your high school. If you're up, there's a lot of high schools that are coming back. Students are going back, you know, within the last week, this week, next, that have internet. You're going to have to do something to get these assignments, because I really just can't keep extending. I've already extended modulars 5 and 6 and 7 for a lot of folks, you know, weeks, couple weeks. This, you know, this time, a lot of this stuff, like I said, if you go back and read here, I'm giving you, you know, basically another sort of another week or a couple more days for some of this stuff. We just can't keep extending deadlines. We can't stall out in October when we still got, you know, the rest of October material that we got to do, all of November. And plus, keep in mind, we do have a Thanksgiving break. So really, November is going to be a short month. We're not going to have the full 4 weeks of November. We're only going to have 3. So if you sort of put that in perspective, we have 3 weeks left. Count this week, 3.5 weeks of October. Then we have 1, 2, 3. So that's about 6.5. So, you know, we have about 7.5, maybe 8 weeks at this point, and we just can't stall out where we're at. And unfortunately, you know, I sympathize with you. I have empathy. I know how it is to, you know, have damaged the property because of these storms, to lose food, to lose power, to not have internet, to be sort of disconnected for a while. It's frustrating. It's hot still. You know, it gets humid depending on where you're at. If you got kids, you know, I have 2 kids. Our power was out for a while too. So, I mean, the young kids, sometimes it's hard for them to really deal with that. So, I sympathize with you. I've been where you're at. Some of us, you know, are fixing to probably have to, I hope, maybe not deal with this again with Milton coming up. But long term, I mean, I don't know how many folks have looked at some of the weather. I mean, this time next week, there's supposed to be another storm sort of developing where Helene and Milton did these last couple weeks. That's something you just want to be mindful of. We're basically just in that season now. And unfortunately, just because, you know, a handful of folks don't have internet, we can't stop class and kind of wait for them to get online, because, you know, if it is the 4 weeks, then we're basically, you know, approaching Thanksgiving at that point, and we still have to cover, you know, 4 or 5 weeks of stuff. So that, I mean, that's going to bog everybody down. It's going to cram everybody. It's not going to be a fun feeling. So that's why we need to get back to some sense of normalcy here, moving forward. So I thank those that have already done some of the work. Some of y'all were working as we had the little time off or the break or whatever the case may be. So if you're caught up, then you may not have to do as much. You can kind of, you know, focus on other classes or focus on the midterm in this class. So you may not have to worry. The problem is, if, because what's going to happen is, and I see this a lot of times when we have storms like this, students say, oh, well, he's giving us the Halloween. That's nearly 2.5 weeks to get everything. Yes, I'm giving you that time, but you still have other work that's happening, you know, this week, next week, the week after. So if you wait until week 10 and have 7 things to do, I mean, of course, you're going to feel overwhelmed, and then you're going to be start saying, well, I need more time. Well, I really can't give you more time. So I wouldn't procrastinate. Again, if you need to find a place that has internet, then you may need to travel to go for it. You may need to do it at work. You may need to do it, you know, high school if you're a dual enrollment student. You may have to travel to a campus. You may have to go to a friend or family's house that has internet. You may have to find a Wi-Fi or a hotspot. But you're going to have to do what you're going to have to do within these next 24 days, because November 1st, really that week 10, we're moving on. We're moving into the last stretch of the semester. And, you know, granted, depending on how this storm at Milton is this week, I mean, right now, they're not even really talking about canceling the college yet. That could come late tomorrow afternoon. That could come, you know, sometime Thursday, because they took so much time off. That may not even come. I don't know. So I would say, if you have internet and you got power, to keep trucking along. If you need to go out and search for that, I mean, obviously do so when it's safe, that type deal. But just keep in mind, you know, by the time Halloween gets here, I'm expecting all the makeup work to be done. If you didn't turn anything in prior to the storm, those items are going to be zeros. We just don't have time to keep going back weeks after week after week. There's deadlines. Somebody said, well, I can't find the checklist. I show you where the checklist is at if you need a checklist. Give me just 1 second. I will show you where you can find that. If you go to your syllabus, your simple syllabus, core syllabus, each deadline is there at the end of that. So I want to use my 1102 course, for example. Some of my 1101s, I had to sort of go in and build the next couple of weeks, because I didn't want to put too much on there right now because of the storm and everything. But if you go up to your simple syllabus, which is right here, you click on that, it's going to take you to another page. It's going to load. And then if you go down here, it says course schedule on Blackboard. It gives you all the due dates, what the assignment is, when it's due, that type deal. So you've all had this course schedule since week one. I'll usually put due dates in the actual lesson folders as well. So you have that to go by. So there's stuff that you can find, and I usually send announcements and emails. So if you're not checking your Coastal Pines email account, that's probably the reason why you're not getting some of these announcements and due dates. And if you go to your announcement page right here, it's going to show all the announcements, like the email I just sent out regarding the deadlines. It's there. I sent it out at 9 o'clock this morning. You should have got an email of that. Sometimes you may have to check the focus or the other or the junk or however you have it set up. But I generally send out due dates and when stuff is due. It's on your syllabus. You're just going to have to take the time to go through it and read it and look at it. Again, all of this stuff has been up since that week one, that, you know, August 18th or whatever it was. The other thing is Respondus. And again, this is for my online courses dealing with 1101 and 1102 specifically. If you're a hybrid, you're going to do your midterm deal in class, because I'm going to be there proctoring you. The Respondus, you will have a proctor. They will. That's the reason why you need to have the webcam and web mic, and they both need to be operational and working and turned on at all times during that particular event. But you're going to have to download this app called the Respondus Lockdown Browser. So basically what happens is, when you go in to take your midterm, it's going to lock your browser down. I mean, you can't go to any other website. You have to stay on this particular page. And you're going to have 60 minutes to do whatever the instructions tell you to do. For my 1101, it's going to be SA4. If you look, if it's not there yet, it will be there soon. I will provide some topics for that particular essay. It's going to be an extended definition essay. When I upload the assignment sheet, it's going to be self-explanatory. It's going to give you, you know, 4 or 5 choices. You pick one. I give you the parameters, how many pages it needs to be, this and that. The deal is, you can't write a rough draft. You can't send a draft to me or a peer or Smart Thinking or tutor.com. Rather, we're not going to even have a peer review for SA4. It's what SA4 does is see how well you can write under pressure. It's a 60-minute exam. So once you start, you have to finish it in one setting. Now, you can go and take bathroom breaks or whatever the case may be, but just kind of keep in mind, your time is ticking. So whatever you don't save, when it comes 61 minutes, it's going to shut down and send whatever's there. If there's nothing there, it gets graded as a zero. If it's only half, you know, halfway completed, well, it's only halfway completed. I can only grade what I can see and read. For those that are in my 1101 class doing the SA4, you can have an outline of your essay. You can have note cards if you choose. That's the only two things, because you're basically doing this by scratch. It's a one and done thing. So once you turn in, you're done. Give it a grade. We'll move on to SA5 as it relates to 1101 and 1010, which is going to be the research paper. If you don't have the lockdown browser, you're never going to be able to take that particular midterm. So it's going to be graded a zero. If there's nothing there, automatically grades as a zero. The other thing is I can't keep resetting and opening it. The college pays for each person to have the access to take a Respondus event. So with that said, I wouldn't open it and I wouldn't click begin unless you're really ready to complete it in one setting. Because again, this back and forth, can you delete this? Oh, something happened. Again, I would make sure that your computer is up to date with all the updates. I would make sure, hopefully, that your internet is stable. Again, if you live in a particular community where your internet is, you know, gets knocked off depending on which way the wind is blowing, I would go to the closest Coastal Pines Technical College library or testing site so you can complete this. Use their equipment, use their internet, use their computer, use their webcam and mic, because you're going to need those things. If you don't have a web mic turned on, if you don't have your camera turned on, I can't grade if we can't see you. The other thing is you need to have a ID of some sort, because before you even get started, they're going to want a picture of your face, your smiling face, and they're going to want a ID that basically verifies the picture that's on their screen. So if you don't have a picture ID, you need to try to find one that has your picture and your name on it. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to proceed to the actual part where you're typing. You're not going to be able to use Microsoft Word. There's going to be a text box, sort of like this, where you're going to be typing your essay. Do the best you can. Again, this is for my 1101 courses. Do the best you can to sort of fit the format, you know, the MLA format. I know it's probably going to be not the best, but as long as I can read, like here, I can read this stuff. The text box will have a spell checker, probably won't have a grammar checker. So make sure that you take time to go back and actually proofread. You're probably going to need at least 40 minutes to type. That's generally the average for most students that have to type that particular essay. It's going to take them 40 minutes. You want to take 10 minutes of that to proofread and edit spelling, grammar, whatever the case may be. And then you want to take the last 10 minutes of that to make sure that you save everything and everything gets submitted. Because you're not going to be able to upload a particular document. You're typing your particular essay using your note cards and using your outline in that text box. Now, for my 1102 students who have to take the poetry, it's going to be exam 2. Poetry is going to be what's going to be your particular Respondus event. And it's going to have, I think, 10 questions. For the most part, the short answer. They deal with the poems that we've read in Modular 6, 7, and 8. I'm going to grant access that you can kind of use your notes for that. If you want to use the, you know, download the poems or have the poems near you, because again, you're not going to be able to access, once you get locked down in that browser, you're not going to be able to Google stuff. That's the whole purpose. So you're not cheating, right? Or using AI or whatever the case may be. So I would recommend that you go back and download or print out the poems in modular 6, 7, and 8. Otherwise, when you go to take the exam, it's just going to be you and whatever you remember, because if you try to go anywhere, it's not going to let you. If it suspects that you're cheating, if you're getting information from somebody else in the room, if you have stuff written on your wall, because it's going to want the camera, it's going to want you to do a 360 of all around your room and look at your notes. If it suspects that you are cheating, it's just going to shut down. And when it shuts down, it's going to send me the video and the signal, and it's automatically going to give you a zero. Going back to zeros at this point, because we're basically 2 months into the semester, the zeros are going to be damaging. If you have multiple zeros, you're probably, depending on how many you get, you may be failing at this point, meaning each zero that you make is going to take you down at least 20 points. So if you have three zeros, you're pretty much at a 40 or lower at this point. What I'm getting at there is there's probably no way that you're going to be able to come back from that. Especially if, I mean, if you didn't turn stuff in prior to the storm, that's probably what's hurting your grade. Even if you did the makeup work and you got, you know, 80s and 90s on most of that stuff, if you're at a 32, I think I got somebody in the class, in one of my classes, has got like a 7. I think they log in just to see their grade, you know, decrease each week, which I don't know what the reason of that is. They probably need to just go ahead and withdraw, because they can make 100s from here to next year, and they probably still wouldn't come up to be a 70 really at this point. So I say that to say this, if you're getting to the point where you're 59 or lower and you got a lot of stuff going on, you know, with other classes, it may be that period that you want to do a little bit of soul searching. You may want to withdraw and retake this in the spring when you can focus and get a better grade. Because the next 8 weeks we're getting into, for, you know, for a lot of us, it's going to be the research portion of the course. It's not the easiest. It's a little bit time consuming because you're going to have to go and get research from libraries. You're going to have to read the stuff, that type deal, on top of other stuff that you're going to have to do for the course. So again, if you're procrastinating, it's not going to be your friend, and it's really going to be, you're going to feel the pressure as it gets closer to Thanksgiving. Because right after Thanksgiving, that's when a lot of this big project and stuff is going to be due for all my classes. On top of the final exam and, you know, if you got 3 other classes or 4 other classes, work, kids, that type deal. Thanksgiving, Christmas, Halloween, you know, all that stuff coming up. So I wouldn't drag my feet on a lot of this stuff. Just because you have 24 days to make up stuff, I wouldn't wait until, like I said, I wouldn't wait until 2 days before Halloween to get everything in. I mean, I think that's really foolish, especially looking at next week and possibly having another storm. Looking toward the end of the semester when we're still in hurricane season, I mean, I just wouldn't wait. If you have a chance to get caught up and get stuff, I would go ahead and do so. Because, you know, I mean, if you're out of power for a day or a week or still out of power, you see how you pretty much need internet these days to get anything done, it seems. So if you have time, I'd get caught up. That way, if you get caught up, you can kind of focus on some of the other stuff or get caught up in another class. I'm not really adding too much new. I mean, it's still stuff that was pretty much on the schedule. If there's something that goes on with the remaining October, meaning if we, you know, have to miss because of a storm or something, we will come back and address and maybe adjust some stuff. But again, I mean, the same deal is, I can't stall out in November because we won't get the last. There's certain things that the college needs me to complete, and that's why we need to sort of stay on track and get that done. So whatever you got to do to get stuff in, to get caught up, I mean, you're going to have to do it. Otherwise, I mean, we're just going to have to move on. And, you know, I hate to say it, but you may have to just eat those zeros if you can't find other means of getting this stuff in. The other thing is, too, some of you are losing points because you're not turning stuff in as Microsoft Word. I'm going to show you here. You know, if you use your Office 365 or your Outlook account, if you go up to this square, right, there's like nine little dots here. You click on that. You click on Word. It's going to take you to your free version of Word where you can type your stuff. You can save it. You can download it and you can upload it. Definitely utilize that. I did show that, I think, week one, week two. So everybody has a free version of Word inside their Office 365 account. Of course, you have to use your student email to be able to get the free version. If you're not using your Coastal Pines email, then you're not probably going to get it. It looks like the vice president has sent out some extended library hours so that you can get some extra time to do your work if you need it because of the deal with your internet and power. This just came out. So if you look, Golden Isles Library, which is basically Brunswick, Glenn County, you have from October 9th to November 1st, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Thursday. They're also open on Friday, 8 a.m. to noon. The Jessup Library, October 8th through the 10th and 14th through the 16th, you have 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Thursday. And then the following, October 11th, 18th, 25th, and November 1st, which are Fridays, you have 8 a.m. to noon again. Waycross, the library is going to be Monday through Thursday, 8 a.m. to 7. You have your Student Success Center. It's going to be October 11th, 18th, 25th, and November 1st. Those are Fridays, 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. I know Camden right now is generally Monday through Thursday, 7:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. We're generally not open on Fridays. Of course, those hours could change here. But I would, you know, if something comes up of Camden, if you live closer to Camden or something of that nature, I will let you know those. But right now, these are those extended hours that if you want to go to the college to use their internet or your Respondus exam or to make up work, we have offered you extended hours up to November 1st. So going back, you will find information on your about Respondus. One, you can find it in your simple syllabus, but there's additional information about how to go about downloading it here. So I would definitely, and I think I mentioned this, you know, a couple weeks ago, if you haven't already, I would go through and look at the video. I look at these instructions. You're going to have to download the right browser to your right particular device. Meaning if you're using Windows, you need to download the Respondus app for Windows. If you're using Mac, you need to download it for Mac. If you're using Chromebook, you're going to have to download it for Chromebook. You can't mix and match because it's not going to work out too well for you. I wouldn't recommend using an iPad. It probably won't work really too well for you there, or a cell phone. I can definitely tell you it's not going to work too well on the cell phone. If you need support, this is some support here. The only thing I can really do as it relates to the actual Respondus program, I mean, it's its own little beast. If you download the right version to your right device, you're okay. It's when you start to mix and match is when you're going to have problems. If it prompts you for a password, the password's already built in. So if you downloaded the right one and did everything correctly on your end, it's going to bypass that. It's just going to know because you did it correctly. So if you email me and ask for a password, I don't know it because I never gave it a password. It's automatic in that particular program. So it's something that you did on your end. I can't control computer issues. So if there's something going on with your computer, if you got a virus, lightning hit it, if it's fried, you know, whatever the case may be, that's on you. The same thing is, I mean, if you still have issues with Respondus, you have some things here that you can kind of go through, troubleshoot, and contact. I would probably contact Respondus for the support, because basically after I load the test, the only thing I can do at that point is, after you turn it in, is read it and grade. I have no control over the program. I can't control what's going on your end of your computer. I can't control what's going on with the response. But I can tell you, if it prompts you for a password, that you did something wrong on your end. Because it's never going to ask for a password if you did it right. You downloaded the right version. Otherwise, I would definitely look at that before you take the Respondus for your particular course. Again, this is mainly for my 1101 online and 1102 online. The other thing, and this is really for 1102, besides the actual exam, you're going to have a research paper, but it's not this time. You do have a poetry essay, and I give you some topics. Going to be due relatively about that same week. Let me go back here. Going to be due by the 31st, which is a Thursday, 11:59. So just kind of keep in mind, you do have some stuff coming up. I would, kind of get caught up as quickly as you can. If you need to go back and do some of the stuff for Modular 6 and Modular 7, I have pushed some stuff back. If you look at the due dates here for a lot of this stuff, as much as I can. It's just, I can't keep delaying stuff. Otherwise, it's going to really screw us up in November. And we're all going to be hating life at that point. If, we're having to do like 15 assignments in 1 week, I don't think you're going to want that. I don't want to have that degrade all in 1 week. I don't want to push that on you. But I mean, if we keep delaying stuff, that's what's going to happen. We're just going to have multiple assignments due, to the point where you're probably going to have one about due every day or every other day. And you don't want to have that in your life, I can tell you. So I think what I detailed in this email is the best thing that you can, best way we can approach this. So either way, and I try to work, between now and the end of the month, try to work as much as I can with folks. But again, I mean, we got to get sort of back on track. We got to get some sort of, normalcy back into our lives. And I hope everybody is doing well. I hope y'all didn't have, really sustain a lot of damage, that you can kind of recover and get back to some sort of normalcy in your life as we head into the holidays, right? As we head into Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's. I hope everybody's family and friends are doing well. I hope nobody got seriously hurt or injured during the storms. And I just pray and hope that everybody gets through this week with this other particular Hurricane Milton coming through the middle of Florida. And we will, I guess, monitor to see how things are next week and the week after. Otherwise, please let me know if you need anything. I can do as much as I can in my power. Again, a lot of this stuff, my hands are tied because it's coming from the top. And I can only control what they sort of, kind of give me guidance on. Otherwise, again, I did send out some extra credit. We will do some additional extra credit. If you checked an email or so before the storm, there is a student survey, instruction survey. I think it had like 7 or 8 questions. Some of y'all have already done that. If you did, I've been putting those points either to one of your lower major grades, whether it's an essay or a test, if you're in my 1102 class. There might be still a couple that I have to go back and actually apply that to. If you haven't completed that survey and you want those 10 points, please do so, because that's a difference between an A and a B, because that is a letter grade, right? 10 points. The other extra credit opportunities I will provide to you, they'll probably be the first week of November, dealing with the library orientation and that type stuff as we get into the research. The other thing is, if you want, because we are basically at the halfway mark, if there is, and this is really for my 1010, 1101 group, if you have a weekly assignment, something that's not an essay, like a peer review or one of those like quizzes or writing critiques that we sometimes do on smaller readings, if there is one that you want me to draw, I can only draw one, whether it's a peer review or one of those weekly quiz writing things, please email me and let me know which one you want me to drop. I'll go ahead and drop that. That will sort of help the grade as well. For my 1102 class, I can drop one of your lowest quizzes or, you know, like discussion question deals, if you have something there. If you want to wait until we get closer to week 15, which is getting into the last week, you can. But just kind of let me know, because I want to give you that opportunity to improve the grade there. All right, so without any other questions or anything else I wanted to say, I'm going to go ahead and end this now. I hope to have something as we get sort of, I hope, back on track for week 9, really for individual classes starting next week. So I hope everybody has a great rest of your Tuesday. Be safe the rest of the week, depending on how the weather is going to be. And I would continually, you know, I would check your email. I would check, you know, the college homepage to see if any kind of closures for the rest of this week. Unless you have like the alert messages, sometimes they send out text messages if you have that signed up on your particular phone or whatever. Otherwise, you're not going to know unless you're checking your email or you're going to the homepage or the Facebook page or whatever the case may be. So please kind of keep that in mind, so you're sort of up to date of whether we're open or not or whatever the case may be. You know, if you're having to travel to a particular college, you probably want to know if it's open or not before you, you know, get halfway here and realize, oh, they're closing because the winds are picking up to 60 miles an hour. I wish somebody would let me know. Well, chances are we probably did. You just didn't check your email. You didn't check your, you know, you didn't get signed up for the warning status on your phone, or you didn't look at the homepage, because you're going to find that stuff all there. All right. I will see you next week. Have a good week.